Hi, welcome back to Fullest Figures. So last weekend I headed over to Birmingham in the UK, over to the NEC where the Vintage Toy Fair was on. It was on the Sunday where there was hundreds of stalls all packed to the gills full of vintage goodness. It really was an amazing toy fair. It's actually the second time I've been there and I'm definitely going the next time. I headed over the day before and was lucky to take off because we had a storm here. So there was a few little delays, but eventually we took off and 50 minutes later I landed in Birmingham and headed down to the hotel. I headed into the bar to say hello to a few people that were already there. One of the first people I met was Adam, the real toy dude. Adam was handing out goodie bags to everyone and I was very lucky to get one too. It was full of vintage kind of goodness. He had put in a card back for everyone and I got this one here, which is absolutely fantastic. If you just take a look at that then, the vintage comic art Boba Fett. What an absolute gorgeous card just to have in the collection. So even though I don't collect vintage collection action figures, this is a stunning piece to have and I will treasure it. Adam had also put in a load of vintage kind of trading cards and I haven't held any of these in years. It wasn't until later on when I went back up to the room and I started kind of flicking through them. The muscle memory of holding a pack of cards back in the day when you'd be in the schoolyard kind of trading them just came back and it was really, and honest to God, such an amazing feeling just to feel, you know, trading cards rummaging through your hands as well. There really are some beauties in this, but if at the back then I came, he'd included some G.I. Joe ones which were really, really stunning. So you can see there we got Grunt, Cobra Commander, Captain Gridiron, we got a Cobra Bat, and then an Honor Roll card with Doc. And of course, Doc is coming to us soon. So this really was an amazing little goodie bag from Adam. So Adam, thank you so much. I can't explain the joy you gave me just flicking through them that evening in the hotel room. And like I said, bringing back all those memories. Next then, I was approached by Sai, our Manga Fandanga, who had this for me, which is a set I've been after for a long time. I never got it back in the day when it came out. And this, of course, is the Black Series Stormtrooper with blast effects. Granted, now this, remember, is in the hotel the day before. I hadn't even got to the toy fair yet, and this is just a stunning piece. So I'm really delighted to add this into my collection, and I'm kind of looking forward to doing sort of a comparison video between this Stormtrooper and other Stormtroopers in the Black Series line, because like I said, this guy just has those scuff marks on him with those blast effects, so that's really, really stunning. I also got to meet Biker Scout, who, again, another guy from the community. I've talked in the chat loads of times over the years. It was really amazing to see him. He was giving everyone a badge, which was a beautiful little thing to get a little memory of meeting Biker Scout for the first time. Biker Scout had a really great time at the event, so I have a funny feeling we'll see him at the next one. I got to meet who I consider a really, really old friend, but only got to meet him for the first time in person last weekend. Scuba Pete, and what a big, generous guy he was. Scuba had brought me over an Action Force figure. He'd asked me recently, hey, are you not getting any away for? And I said, no, I was holding out because it's just costing so much getting these shipped into the Ireland from the US. And then when they get here, you get hammered with custom charges. So I said, no, I'm holding off to maybe try and get a few things together. He got me the Swarm Tracer, which is a glow-in-the-dark figure. This is a stunning, stunning figure from Valorverse. Now, I had avoided kind of getting the bad guys or the sci-fi looking guys, but I think Scuba Pete's after opening a can of worms for me here, because I'm really impressed with this and I can't wait to get it out and take a closer look at it. I'm definitely going to do a video on this. But he didn't stop there. The big generous head that he is also included the camouflage version of Blowback, which of course comes with the ghillie suit, the sniper rifle, all this extra goodness. So again, I was just blown away by your generosity. Thank you so much, Scuba. Again, can't wait to get these out, take a closer look at them and do a video on them. I'm so thrilled to have these in my collection, but I'm just astounded at your generosity looking all these over from the United States to here, well, in the UK for me. You're very kind. Scuba, of course, is on the Chasing 80s YouTube channel. And he also has his own, The Scubas with his wife, where they kind of showcase their adventures. So please make sure you go check out those two channels. Hugely generous gift. And like I said, can't wait to get these out and do a video on them. So finally, the next morning came. A few of us met up for breakfast and headed on around to the NEC to the toy fair. Now, while I was in the airport waiting to go over to the UK, Lawrence from A Punk With Toys reached out to me and said, "Hey Connor, have you any Power of the Force figures? I'm looking to do something in a couple of weeks' time." I said, "No, but I'm going to a vintage toy fair. I'll see what I can pick up." So not something I was after, but I did end up getting a carded Power of the Force Jedi Luke Skywalker. And this, I think, was only £10, which is an incredible price when you consider that they are a vintage toy line now. And look at the condition of that card. It's absolutely beautiful. So I then faced a challenge. I didn't want to have to go and take this beautiful figure off the card. So if I was doing something with it, I was going to need a loose version. I ended up spending the day hunting for a loose Jedi Luke from the Power of the Force. I did manage to finally track one down near the end of the day, actually, as it happens. Now, he doesn't have his lightsaber, but hopefully by tracking down this loose version of Luke Skywalker, it means I won't have to take him off the card. Now that my mission to get my Power of the Force figure was complete, and I chalked that one off, it meant that I could finally look around for something else I wanted to pick up. Now, granted, remember, I had nothing in mind. I just wanted to see what may come. So I had no kind of inkling as to what I might want to pick up there. Also, I didn't have a lot of room left in my carry-on bag after the generosity of the guys the day before. But I came across a stall and they had these vintage O-ring 18 figures. And I had to pick them up because the condition of them were absolutely beautiful. They really were in great condition. The paint is just immaculate on them. So I got B.A. Baracus. These guys didn't come with accessories, but again, didn't mind that given the really beautiful condition of the paint on these guys. So these were from different play sets back in the day. I think it was the camp or kind of play set that we got one Christmas of Santa Claus, me and my brother. And I think my brother had got the van that year as well, which goes along with these Galoob figures. So I just had to pick them up. But look at the stunning condition of that. Absolutely gorgeous. That's BA. Also got Hannibal. And again, really just gorgeous condition. Look at the paint apps on that. Are just immaculate. This figure's over 40 years old, or around 40 years old. And look at the gorgeous paint still on that. I got, of course, face. Little bit of scuff on face. Little tiny scuff on the eyebrow there. But outside that, he's really kind of stiff joint still on this guy in comparison to the other ones. And I just was so impressed to get that. And I used to love playing with these because I was able to mix these figures in with my Star Wars figures and my Action Force figures back in the day when setting up sort of play situations. So that was cool. And then, of course, one of my favorite as a kid, Howlin' Mad Murdoch. So again, great paint apps on this guy. Look how squeaky clean he is. So really just stunning. Few little scuff marks on the cap there, but you know, the overall condition of the figure is so good. I really didn't mind that. So that was literally, I think, one of the four stalls I happened across. I ended up picking up bang, 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 those four figures. But again, you know, so amazing to have these included now in my collection, and like I said, beautiful paint apps on them. There's not even much, I won't even need to touch them up or replace them. Hopefully, maybe I can track down some accessories in time, but outside that, I was really happy with those. Now, next up, I picked up one of my favorite figures growing up as a kid, and that was Airtight. And this guy, I suppose because his weapon is a bit peculiar, it wasn't like a gun, it was sort of this thing here where it would sort of suction the air or something. He wasn't really, I know he has his haters out there, but I love this because it meant that whenever I wanted to put a G.I. Joe figure or an Action Force figure into my X-Wing fighter, I could do it with this guy because he had the helmet on. He's just like a pilot. And I loved this figure growing up. I always grabbed him at playtime. And again, he's pretty beautiful condition. Got the backpack. He's got the mouthpiece then, which is very hard to get. And of course, he has his weapon with the hose. So that was a complete airtight figure. And I'm going to use the word yellow in here. It's yellow. A bit of fading there on the elbows. But outside that, the paint on this guy is just perfect. So I couldn't say no to him. I had to pick him up. And then the last thing I picked up was General Hawk. And this is because I wanted to do a General Hawk video. And again, just astounded at the condition of this figure. Again, a 40-year-old figure, but he was complete. So he had his backpack. He had his helmet. Just pop it on. And of course, he had his sidearm as well. So really beautiful example of General Hawk. It's in great condition. It's complete. There's no way I could have said no to this. What a gorgeous figure. So, like I said earlier, I can't wait to go back to the NEC Toy Fair. It was, for me, a really successful trip. So there you are, folks. That's my haul from the NEC Vintage Toy Fair in Birmingham from last weekend. Really was a wonderful time. I was so blessed that I got to meet so many wonderful people that were at the show. I met some for the first time. I met people that I've met the past couple of times I've been in the UK. It really was a well worthwhile trip. Not only for the social side of it, which was great fun, but also for the pickups. I'm really looking forward to the next one in September. I'm planning on going. And if you happen to be there and see me, please do say hello, because a big part of this, you know, gig for me or doing these videos is the social side and getting to meet other collectors out there. Thanks so much for watching my video. I really appreciate it. If you'd like, you can follow me over on Instagram at Fuller's Figures, where I like to post fairly regularly. But if nothing else, I really hope I see you on the next one.